Hello everyone and welcome back to another Blender Made Easy tutorial. Today we're going to be using Blender to create a solar eclipse. So this is a fun tutorial. There's a lot of tricks and techniques that we're going to be using to create this effect. So make sure you're in the new version 2.79 and then Cycles Render is enabled. So first off, let's delete the cube. So press X and delete it, then press Shift A. We're going to go to Mesh and then UV Sphere. This is going to be the moon. So if we zoom in here, we can see that it's very low poly, and if we set up the camera and do the rendering, you'll be able to see the polygons on the left and on the right side, the edges. It's not going to look that great. So we need to add in a subdivision surface modifier. So to do this, we can go to the modifier section and click add modifier, or we can hit Ctrl 2. That will add in a subdivision surface on top of it for us. Click smooth shading over on the left side in the toolbar, and then I'm also going to press T to close that off. So we have a little bit more room in the window. Next, what we need to do is add in the HDR so we can actually position the camera and the sun in the background. So go over to the world settings and click use notes. Now for this color, this little button on the right, this little dot, click this and select environment texture. Once you do that, we'll be able to open up the HDR and position it. So click open and navigate to wherever you have your HDRs. And what I'm going to be using is an HDR from the Architecture Academy. If you have the Architecture Academy, you can use the same one as me. Or if you don't have it, you can download a free HDR. Link is down in the description. So the one that I'm going to be using is 004 half. So click on this and select open image. Now press Shift Z and we'll be able to see the HDR. Now what I recommend is an HDR that doesn't have a lot of glare on the sun. We can see this one, there's not a lot of glare. Some HDRs that I've noticed have like lens flares or streaks and it doesn't look that great. So try to find an HDR that does not have that streak. This one works perfectly fine. We can see that there is some clouds covering the sun a little bit, but that is okay. We're gonna position the moon and stuff and we're gonna darken the world so you won't even notice it. Next, what we're going to do is position the camera. So press Ctrl+Alt+0 to snap the camera into place. I'll zoom in a little bit and then I'll right click on it. Next, press Shift Z and what we need to do is just move it and position it till it's over there. Also, I'm going to lock the camera to the view. Most of the time I don't like to do this, but for this I think it just makes it a little bit easier. So select Lock Camera to View and then just position the camera right around here, move it up. Somewhere around there looks good. And I want to zoom out so it's pretty far, right around there. And I'll drag it down. So there we go. The moon is positioned in front of the sun. Next, I want to turn up the focal length so the camera is a lot closer. So right click on your camera, make sure it's selected, go over to the camera settings and turn up the focal length to a very high number. I found that like 180 is a pretty good number, so let's go 180. There we go. And then G and just move it over to the right just a little bit so it's positioned. Let's press Shift Z, see how this looks. There we go, it looks a little bit better. Let's turn down the world settings and see how it looks with it really dark. So let's go with a value of 0.09. 0.09, Shift Z, we'll see what this looks like. There we go, that looks much better. We can see that there's some lighting over here and there's some clouds and some detail in the HDR. Perfect. All right, I'm gonna press N and I'm gonna uncheck lock camera to view so I can get out of it really quickly. And we can see that the camera is really stretched because we turned up the focal length. All right, so now let's make the sun. So on this one, I'm just gonna press Shift D and move it back just a little bit. Now go into camera view and position it right in the back. And then we'll scale it up just a little bit. I'll position it down, scale it up just a tad bit more. You want to make sure that the sun on this side is peeking out just a little bit more than it is on the right. So maybe right here, and I'll scale it down. To make this a little bit easier to see, I'm going to add in a new material. So go to the Material tab and select New. Change the surface to Emission and set the strength to a value of 10. Shift Z and we'll see how this looks. So we can see that the ring is now like that, and that looks pretty good. I want to move it just a tad bit this way, just up just a little bit so it peeks through the right side. There we go. And then maybe this way up a little bit as well. Something like that. So we can see that the right side is a little bit thinner and then the left side's a little bit thicker. So it's kind of moving this way. That's the effect that I'm going for. And I think that works. Another thing that I want to do is add in a little bulge right around here. Just a little thing peeking out to give it some variation, and I think it will look a little bit better. So having the sun selected, I'm just gonna shift D this, right click and scale downwards. Press Z so we can see it a little bit better, and then move it over here. So we have just this little tiny thing just like that. I'll position it right about there. Shift Z, we'll see what this looks like. There we go, just a little bump right there, I think will add some cool effects. Okay, the next thing that we're gonna be doing is adding a texture to the moon that's in front. So to do this, I went to Google and I just typed in moon texture and this first one right here. I clicked on view image and then this popped up. I think this works perfectly fine. So once you right click on it, you can save it and then go back to Blender. So for this moon, click new on this and select this little button on the right and click on image texture. Click open and navigate to where your image is. Mine is right here, solar eclipse and moon.jpg. Open that up. And now we need to UV unwrap this. So go into edit mode by pressing tab, then click U and go sphere projection. Now let's open up the node editor and see what this looks like. So in this top right corner, I'm just gonna drag out a new window, then click on this little button and select UV image editor. We can see how the UV sphere is unwrapped, which is all right, it's okay. It's not the best UV unwrapping, but we'll just see how it looks with the texture. So let's click on this button and select moon. And just give it a second because that's a pretty big image. There we go. So let's go into textured view mode. So go into textured view and zoom in. And it actually looks pretty good. I might want to scale it up just a tad. That's not too bad though. We got some details up here. We got some details down there. Maybe rotate it around. Yeah, there we go. So just find a position that you like. Probably around there is good. So you get some detail up there. I think that looks perfectly fine. And for the displacement, I'm just gonna select Voronoi texture and just turn up the scale quite a bit. So if we look at the preview, we can see what the Voronoi texture is doing with the displacement. It looks kind of cool actually. I think this would look good for like a low poly scene, but we need to turn it up quite a bit. So for the scale, I'm gonna set it to 250. And we can see that there's a lot of bumps all around here. So we'll see what this looks like. Shift Z. And there we go. Not too bad. All right, let's close off this window. Then press Z twice to get rid of that. And also you could see that there's a little bit of lighting, and that is because this lamp is right here. So I'm gonna right click on it and delete it. Go back into camera view and we'll see what this looks like one more time. Not too bad. We get some detail right here, and then the moon and the sun looks really good. All right, I think we're ready to do a render. So go over to the render settings. I'm going to turn up the resolution all the way up, and I think the world settings should be just a tiny bit brighter. Let's go with like point one. We'll see what that looks like. I think that's a little bit better, so we can see just a little bit more detail in the moon. All right, for the world settings, the sampling I think is fine, just at 120, maybe a little bit lower so it goes faster, 100, and I think we're good to go. So once you do that, save your project by hitting Ctrl S. I'm just gonna call it tutorial solar eclipse. There we go. And hit render. So this should not take too long, only 100 samples. I'm running on my GPU right now. Should be done very, very quickly. There we go, we can see the remaining is only like 5 seconds and done. All right, so there we go, and it looks terrible, and that is because we haven't done any compositing. And when we do the compositing, we'll add some glares and it will look 10 times better. So let's go up to this window and select compositing. Check the use nodes button and backdrop. I'm also gonna close out both of these windows because we're not gonna need them. So drag this to the right and then drag this window down. Then hit N to close off that panel. All right, so let's right click on the render layers and I'll drag it over to the left. Then I'm gonna hit Control Shift left click on this render layers panel. That will add in a viewer node so we can actually see what we're doing in real time. Click V a couple times to zoom out the image. You can also press Alt V to zoom it back in and then V to zoom out, just like that. All right, so let's add in the glare. So press Shift A, we're gonna go Filter and then Glare. We're gonna be adding three different glares to our scene. There we go. We can see that once we've added this in, it's made a dramatic difference. Everything looks just a little bit crazy. So for these settings, let's just go through. The color module, I'm gonna turn this up just a tad, give it some color. This mix value, what this does, you'll be able to see what the glare looks like just by itself. If we turn this up to 1, everything else in the scene, the background, the moon, and everything will become black, and we'll be able to see what the glare looks like. This is just the glare, and it looks pretty bad. This threshold controls the amount of glare there is. If I turn it really low, there'll be more glare. If I turn it higher, there'll be less glare. So I'm gonna turn it up till we get exactly what we want, a little bit higher. This fade, this will kind of fade it out. So if I go lower, you'll be able to see what it does. It kind of shrinks in the sides just like this. I think that looks a little bit better. You can also, if you turn up the quality to high, we can, if we zoom in here, we can see that the over on the right side, there's just a bunch of light streaks. If I turn it to high, those will disappear. It also takes a second because the quality, if you turn it to high, it goes a little bit slower. We can see it didn't get rid of it completely, but it helped just a little bit. I think that looks better. So let's change the mix back to 0 and bring back our scene. And there we go. And on this glare, I'm going to Shift D this and place it right here. Also connect it to the viewer node. This one is going to be a medium quality. I want this one to be a little bit kind of like lens distortion sort of thing. So we're going to leave it at medium. I'm going to turn up the threshold to a value of 4. I think that will look a little bit better, so give it a second. And nope, still needs to go higher. Let's try 7. I want to bring these sides in just a tad. There we go. So we have some sort of glare right there, maybe like the lens messed up or something like that. I think that looks good. One more glare that we're going to be doing is a fog glow. So Shift D that and change this to fog glow. We'll position this in the viewer node as well. Turn the threshold down to 2 and we'll see what this looks like once it loads. We can see it added quite a bit of glow. I'm going to turn the size down just a tad. I think that will shrink it back up. There we go. And let's see what this looks like with the mix set to 1 so we can just see the fog glow. There we go. We can see that it goes all the way around and it just gives it kind of a soft effect. I think it looks nice. I might turn the threshold down just a tad. So 1.7, and I'll turn the mix back to 0. There we go. That looks pretty good. All right, it's looking great so far, but I want to add some color in the light. So I'm going to press Shift A. We're going to go to Color and then Color Balance. Place that right here and drag this into the viewer node. So we have three different settings right here. The first one is the shadows, the second one is the midtones, and the last one is the highlights. So for the shadows, I'm just going to drag it up just a tiny bit so we can see the moon just a little bit better. We'll give that a second to load and we can see a little bit more detail. The highlights, I want to give it a bluish color, just a tiny bit, so the light will have kind of like a bluish sort of color. There we go. For the midtones, I'm just going to drag this down to where the red is. I think that will look a little bit better. And there we go. Not too bad. I might do it a little bit more. I'll drag it down. I want to give the whole scene kind of a reddish feel, but the light a blue feel. There we go. Not too bad. Last thing I'm going to do is add a vignette. So press Shift A, we're going to go to Color and then Mix, plug that in right here, and drag it into the viewer node. This will turn everything white, but don't worry about it, we'll fix it in just a second. I'm going to press Shift A, we're going to add in a distort and lens distortion. This will distort the edges of the camera. Then Shift A, we're going to add in a filter and then blur. This will blur it. So what we need to do is take the lens distortion and plug it into the blur node. Change the distort to 1, and then take this and plug it into the mix node. We can see it gives this sort of effect. So what we need to do is blur this so it's not so sharp. So change this to fast, click on relative, and this is the percentages of the corners. So 20%, this will blur at 20%. You'll be able to see what it looks like. There we go, we can see it blurs it out like that. If you want to, you can go a little bit lower. Let's try 15% on both of these. That will give the edges a little bit darker. I think that will look a little bit better. And now we need to change the mix to multiply. What multiply does is it takes the white values and gets rid of them. So let's drag this to multiply, and it will grab the white and get rid of them. And then this factor controls how much vignette there is. So if I turn it like really low, this will mostly disappear. Just give it a second to load. There we go. If I turn it all the way up, you'll be able to see. I'm gonna go with a value of 0.7. I think that value will work pretty good. It will darken up the edges so the focus is on the center of the image. There we go, not too bad. All right, so let's go back to the default view. And then this is our render result, which looks terrible. It doesn't look that great. There's no glare, nothing. And then this is our viewer node where there's some glare, and I think it looks so much better. So that is going to be it for this tutorial. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed or if you learned something new, if you created your own image, I'd love to see that. So make sure to post it in the comments or tag me on Twitter, Instagram, all that. Make sure to subscribe for more tutorials, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.